Hi, thank you for joining, and we're going to touch on a very, very, very interesting subject, and that's the tools of Photoshop. I'm using Photoshop CS5. I haven't upgraded to 5.5, but anyone who has Photoshop, I would say, would be able to take from what I'm talking about and use it on their particular version. Things do change. Things have gotten a lot better. Photoshop is an amazing tool, and I think you know that. That's why you're probably looking at this video right now. But I think what you want to get from this video is a way to understand Photoshop in a deeper, more, let's say, particular area. That would mean, for example, understanding the tools, and knowing that you have also the fact that tools have underlying things that are kind of hidden. They're not really hidden, but they are. Unless you know where to look and what you're going to do with the tool, then you'll better understand where to go to get that particular tool to do what you want to do. Right now it sounds very kind of nebulous and you don't understand what I'm saying, but as we go along, you'll get the gist of what this series is going to be about. And yes, this is going to be a series. I'll be touching on a few things today, and then I'll try my best to do one every week for you. Okay, here we are in Photoshop, and we have an image that I did for a t-shirt, and they wanted it to look or have some, you know, resemblance to Tron, and it's, you know, it's a music studio, so this is what was designed for them. I'm not showing it to you for any particular reason or even advertising for them, but to have something up so that we can work with. One of the things that I think is most important to a new person to Photoshop is understanding image sizes and how they fit into print and web. So we'll start with image and image sizes today. And if you go up to the top menu, you'll see it's the third one to your right, and you'll see mode, adjustments, tone, auto contrast, color, image size, canvas size, and image rotation. That's so that you can actually rotate the image. We'll get into all of them eventually. Let's talk about what this image is about. Okay, this particular image is, as you can see up here, it's a JPEG, and there are different formats, and the different formats are for the different uses for that image. For example, JPEG is used mostly for, you might want to write this down if you don't know this, web. It is a very low resolution image, and it's created that way so that it could be used without hard or long loading time on the web itself, so that most people use the JPEG and the GIF. Sorry, I was picking up a paper there. Okay. Let's see what happens about the size. I'll go to the size, and you'll see that it'll give you some information on there, and that's what we're going to talk about today, is about size and resize. Okay. Right here you have a width and a height, and then you have numbers that are given about what they are, and then this is the same information, only it's in inches, and it talks about the document. What is the document? The document is the whole image as it is. Now, what does it mean by pixel dimensions is how many pixels there are to make up this image. Well, if you took this number and you multiplied it by this number, you'll get the amount of pixels that it takes to make up this image. Now, what is a pixel? Let's go a little bit deeper. That's why we say this is about secrets. Okay, if I enlarge this to that size, you can see that there's little squares. Those little squares are varying degrees of shade or color. This happens to be a black and white, so you're going to have varying degrees of shade, not particularly color. And that's what we mean by pixel. So it takes that many pixels to create that image. So let's take it back down, and you'll see that once it gets back to its original size, it will get into focus and look a lot better. Now, back to the image size, and we'll see something about this window here that we need to really understand, because a lot of times people will not know how big an image is going to print, how it's going to, you know, are you creating an image big enough to fit in an area that you want it to fit into? So you start off with a measurement that you need to begin with. If you're creating something entirely new, that dimension will be your starting point. Now, so let's see how that works. So we'll start a new image. So we'll go up to File, create a new one, and then it'll ask you, okay, what do you want? Then here we have various situations for your image. For example, if you already know it's going to be a US paper image, international paper image, a photo, a web page, a mobile device, a film or video, and then it gives you the size that you have already up, which is interesting because I don't think if you didn't have one, I don't think that would be up. Let's put it that way. But I'm going to stay with custom, and the reason why I'm staying with custom because we're going to see how these presets can be of use, but they're not entirely. But even before going to custom, I'm going to go over and we're going to see what the default size is. Okay, the default size is 7 inches by 5 inches and 72, and it's an RGB color. Now, RGB compared to bitmap, grayscale, and CMYK and lab color are things to remember. If you're working with a grayscale image and you don't need that much color, you don't need color information at all, then you want to stay away from, to grayscale. Bitmap, that's working with very, 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 very hard colors, not too much gradation. So you might want to stay away from there. There's going to be reason for bitmaps, there's going to be reasons for grayscale, and there's going to be reason for RGB color and on down. RGB is mainly for video because it deals with colors that are in set up in three color ranges, and that's the red, green, and blue. And the red, green, and blue make up the images that you see on your television, on just about anything that's video, on your computer screen, and so on. So this would be the colors or the color mode that you want to be in if you're creating something for the web, for example. CMYK is for printing, and CMYK works in a four color process, meaning that there are four colors that make up all the colors of the rainbow, and shades and what have you for printing. And those colors are cyan, that's the C, M is magenta, Y is yellow, and K is black. Now, those are the colors that you're going to be using, or the printer will be using, when he prints. So therefore, you have to have your work, if you're going to have it printed, in CMYK format. Lab color is a subject that it's very, 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 very difficult to explain at this particular moment, so we'll come back to it. All right, we're going to stay with RGB right now and go back up here to the custom and what have you. Let's look at U.S. paper and see what they give you. We went to the default size and saw what that was. That's 7x5x72. And then we'll go to U.S. paper, and they give you an 8.5x11, and it's 300 resolution. We're going to talk about resolution a little bit too, okay? And then we'll go to international and see what international paper size is, and we'll find that it's millimeters. Now, what is a millimeter? If we go to inches, we'll see that it's 8.268 by 11.693. now, that's pretty close to 8.5 by 11, but there are different sizes for international papers, just like there's different sizes for U.S. paper. Okay, photo, what is the photo size? And they're giving you, you know, just a approximate photo size is 3x2, but we all know that there's different sizes of photos, and they'll give you that pull down menu so that you can choose that also. And being that these are open so that you can change, you can actually make your photo whatever size you want to make it. And that goes for anything else that you're creating here. Web, it's 640 pixels by 480. And please notice that when working with web, they're most often interested in pixel dimensions. They're not interested in size, but they're kind of, you know, interchanged, and they're kind of substituted for one another. But if you hear pixels, don't get scared. You can always find out what a pixel is in inches, or an inches is in pixels. Just I'll come back here and put in the inch sign, check and see, like I did with pixels to inches, and you'll see what it is. You can actually write down the inch size and then type in the inch size and then go to pixels, and then you'll find out what you know, if you got it right, or if it's not right, you can always fix it. Anyway, so that's that. Now we'll go to mobile devices, see what they're saying. That's pretty much what they're giving you, and that changes quite a bit too. And here are some variations of it. So, you know, you're given some options to work with when working with mobile devices. Okay, film and video. You have a whole slew of things, and there's actually a lot more than this. We'll talk about that right now, just to fill you in on what Photoshop can do for you. As far as a Photoshop artist, you should be able to understand the different formats that you're working with or for, so that you can create those things for your clients. If you're interested in becoming a Photoshop artist, and you want to be able to have a range